I grew up with horses and animals. I grew up on a farm in southern Illinois. My father became a farmer, but actually he was a horseman. It was a tight community, and he was an outsider because he was born 4 miles away in Chobanier, Illinois. So they were shocked when he raised horses, I mean saddle horses, fine horses, horses that went to carriages, when they all invested their money in draft horses, sturdy horses, horses that plowed the field. And if they happened to have a saddle horse for one of their kids, they still put that horse to the plow when it's plowing season. When I was 3 and 4 years old, I could ride a horse by myself as long as I didn't have a saddle, so I could fall off clean, as he put it. In the middle period of my life, I get this commission to paint horses, big horses, Kentucky Derby horses, thoroughbreds. And it was all set up for me to go to Paris, Kentucky, and do these paintings at Secretariat. And they appeared in the Great American Sports Book. And every day I would drive up, and there was an extraordinarily ugly little dog that met me every day. And I thought, oh, he really likes me. And he had, his legs were too short, his head was too big, his had a lot of fur on his, hair on his body, none on his feet, and none on his face. Darndest looking dog I ever saw in my whole life. Became very fond of him. But I learned that he was Secretariat's guide. It was his job, or he considered his job, to come down to the car and escort me to the stable every morning. They permitted me to take my stool and go into Secretariat's stall, and I established myself in one corner. So I sat on a nice pile of clean hay or straw over in this corner, and Secretariat stood, and he's a big horse, over on this side, but he was very curious about me, and he was curious why I was there. I wore a straw hat. I went in every day with a straw hat on, and he always had to nuzzle my hat off. He had to push it off with his nose, and I'd put it back on. It was a little game we played, and every day he would come and he would take my, finally he took my hat off, I mean with his teeth. He simply took it off and ate it up. So now we move outdoors in the broad sunlight, and the ugly little dog is there watching what I do, and I'm setting up, and I have my paper, and I'm going to do a full-size sketch of Secretariat. And Secretariat goes into his pose. He fluffs up his mane. Oh, if he had a hand, he would have done this, because he shook his mane out. He put his ears absolutely forward, put his white feet, three white socks, where they would show, and then he started looking around. And I said to the groom, what is the matter? What am I doing wrong? He said, you're not doing anything wrong, but he hasn't had an artist sketch him, and he wonders why the light bulbs aren't going off. Affirm was a beautiful horse, also a bay. I was at the barn when Affirm was being washed down. Seattle Slough, when I painted him, was absolutely a gentleman. He was the calmest horse. And then they tell me that he wasn't so much like that when he was in racing, still racing. I did the yearling sales at Lexington. It's a big painting. I had to do a lot of maneuvering to do this painting because there were all these VIPs in the audience. But anyhow, I was there when they sold the $1 million yearling. Would I like to paint another horse? Yes, I would. I know horses, and I present a real portrait of the horse. People recognize it.